like to go with the fact that mistakes happen, but in all, we all have to be responsible for our actions, and I feel that there should be some outcome here.
A woman who was run over on a Volusia County beach in July is speaking exclusively to the Today Show about this life-changing accident.
Meanwhile, Wesh, too, has learned the former lifeguard who ran over her in a beach patrol truck has been cited by the Florida Highway Patrol. Wesh News' Claire Matz joining us live right now from Daytona Beach. And Claire, is this guy still working for beach patrol?
No, Martha, he is not. 21-year-old Thomas Mottery was a part-timer, and before the accident, he had noticed the county. He was leaving to join the military. Shortly afterward, he did just that. Now, FHP had been awaiting blood test results, and today they say Mottery had not been drinking or using drugs at the time of the crash. However, he was cited for careless driving with serious bodily injury.
I'm not feeling a whole lot on my face itself on that side.
Erin Joint appeared this morning on the Today Show with her husband and her two young children. They were witnesses to the tragic end of a summer vacation in Volusia County. Early on the morning of July 31st, Joint was sunbathing while her husband and kids played in the shallow water. The lifeguard in a big beach patrol truck made a U-turn out of the traffic lanes, unaware she was there.
It actually went over the right side of my head and down my back.
Joint suffered a skull fracture, broken ribs, a collapsed lung. The left side of her face is still paralyzed. And attorney John Phillips says there is psychological damage. Daughter Hannah told Matt Lauer she tried to protect her five-year-old brother.
I just turned him around and made sure he didn't even know what was going on.
So you kind of kept him distracted.
I kept him distracted so he wouldn't go through the pain that I thought.
Joint is one of a number of people injured by vehicles on the beach. Last summer, two children were killed. Since then, county leaders have made safety changes, including new signage warning of children at play. And they vowed to remove most of the beach patrol's big F-150s that sit so high up and can do so much damage. But that won't protect them from legal action. Joint's lawyer has notified the county of intent to sue. The young Kansas mother only learned today that the former lifeguard has been issued a citation.
We all have to be responsible for our actions, and I feel that there should be some outcome here.
I talked to Erin Joint's lawyer this morning. He says she's undergoing more surgery this coming Monday. Now, as for that intent to sue, he says it's certainly possible that he could settle with the county. He has not actually filed the lawsuit yet, so there is some discussion going on. He says he is seeking at least $1 million. Reporting live in Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WeshTU News.